The following video presentation is brought to you by the UVM Alumni Association.
First, I'd like to start off by giving a few thank yous. First, to Lori. She's been really, really supportive of me through this whole process and transition. And I'm really excited for their season, watching them practice. You know, they're going to play an exciting brand of basketball, and I know they will be much better this year, and I can't thank her enough for everything she's done for me the last 4 or 5 months since I've gotten this job, and look forward to our continued relationship and watching them play this year. I'd also like to thank Dr. Bob Cornyn, the athletic department, staff in general, again, for all the support through this transition. It's made it as seamless as possible, and I really do appreciate it. And lastly, but not leastly, I want to thank my staff. I have a great group of assistant coaches that have really been supportive of me and have really worked really hard to get our guys ready and recruiting and everything we've done. These guys have been great to me and our student athletes. And they're all going to be really good head coaches one day. And I want to just give a heartfelt thank you to them. So about our team, you know, we are really excited for this season. Last season did not end like we wanted to. We had a great regular season, but it did not end the way we wanted to. So everyone involved in this program that was here last year is motivated to not let what happened last year happen again this year. You know, as far as goals, you know, our goal is to finish in the top half of this conference. It's been that every year I've been here, and that will not change. You know, we understand that the winner of the America East Tournament has come from the one or two seed, you know, every year. And so that, you know, that's our goal. We want to be in a position to play our best basketball in March and have a chance to win the America East Tournament. You know, we've been preaching to our guys and all year and through practice that, you know, we are really focused on the process, and we believe the result will take care of itself. And you know, we really want to do the best we can every drill, every day in practice, every game we play. We want to be the best we can be every day, every drill. And we believe if we have that mentality, that the results will take care of themselves, especially at the end of the year. You know, looking at our team this year, obviously we lost Evan, Joey, and Garrett, but you know, the scoring of Evan on the low post and Joey on the perimeter is something that we need to replace. You know, we don't have a go-to guy right now. Brendan Bald was tied for second in scoring for us, and you know, but we haven't had a guy that's done it game in and game out that we can depend on. And so, you know, scoring the basketball, finding that guy, you know, until we can find that go-to guy and until he emerges, we're going to be kind of scoring by committee, and you know, we're going to need Matt Glass and Brendan to score and Brian Boquel to increase his scoring a little bit, and Sandro and Ben and Pat Bergman, who's had a good preseason. So until we can figure that out, we're going to have to figure out a way to score by committee. I know we're going to play defense. I know we're going to rebound. Those are staples of our program and will continue to be the staples of our program. So, you know, we returned 4 starters, which is great, but, you know, with only 4 upperclassmen, we're still a relatively young team. We have a huge sophomore class. The 3 freshmen we brought in, 2 of them, Chris Santo and Four McGlynn, you know, will play this year. You know, especially Four has ability to score the basketball. So, you know, as soon as they get up to speed on the defensive end of the court, I think both those guys will contribute this year. So we're looking forward to seeing how they do this year. Schedule-wise, we have a really tough non-conference schedule, which I think will prepare us for the America East schedule this year. There's going to be some great games here in Patrick Gym, which I'm excited about. Siena comes in, Iona, Harvard comes in here, back on our schedule. Northeastern, an old America's foe, is back on our schedule and comes to Patrick. And Quinnipiac comes up here this year with Garvey Young, an old Catamount, eligible to play, will be back in Patrick gym. So that should be an interesting night. We have some tough road games down in South Florida open up. St. Louis, who is picked third by many in the Atlantic 10 and NCAA team, we go out there and play them with Coach Rick Majerus, which should be a great experience for our guys. We play the night before Thanksgiving. We play down at ODU, another NCAA tournament team. So a good, tough, challenging schedule, which is something we want to do here, continue to do, get our guys ready for the America's play. So we're very excited for the year. It's going to be very competitive America East this year. We're just going to take it game by game, practice by practice, and we're hopeful and excited that the results will be there at the end of the year. I want to thank the media for coming out here today and for all the people here that came out from inside this building. Thank you very much for all the support, and looking forward to the year.